The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome, everybody, to another exciting edition of the Power Trading Hour. And, of course, as always, we love it when you are here at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
And we've got the Fed just came out with their announcement. Probably the big news is that we had four people thinking that they'd raise rates on the board in 2021. That went to seven this cycle. And so people are thinking that's a little bit more. I don't think it's as big a news as most people think. In fact, I think by next Monday, most everybody's going to have forgotten it by a little bit, because it's not like they're pushing the buttons tomorrow. It's just a forecast. And of course, those forecasts, about as good as their inflation forecast, wasn't it? 1%, 1%, 1%, 8%. They jumped the shark quite often. But don't be surprised. The TLT pretty much sitting right around unchanged from yesterday. It did get a little higher today. But you know what? My guess is a little bit of overreaction. A lot of people thinking the end of the world is nigh, like those people you always find in New York City out there in Times Square. I wonder if they still have them. I know they have the cowboy that continues to play in his underwear, play guitar out there. But there was always a guy with the dreadlocks, right out of the movies. And maybe it was the same guy. I don't know. Always saying the end is nigh. And, of course, you woke up another day and, well, you know what? The end wasn't nigh. I suspect that there will be some reactions, but for the most part, just a little bit of market gas. A lot of stocks over the last few days just way up there on the tips of their skis. So they need to come back a little bit. But, somebody says in the den, they're bluffing. I don't know if they're bluffing so much as they're making a lot of prognostications that, you know, can change tomorrow. Who's that? I can't remember the guy that says it on Larry's show yesterday's call for the futures. I'll have to look it up during the break now. But it's always it's always one of those things, right? You think that you know what the future is, but guess what? You're generally fairly wrong about it. I thought that by now, the Jetsons, I'd have my little car and the robot that cleaned up the house. And guess what? Maybe they've got one that vacuums the floor a little bit. That's it. Any flying cars? Well, kind of, but nothing that everybody has. Little tubes, like gerbil tubes that we go to each other's houses in, like we get sucked through. No, nothing like that. Elon Musk did not deliver us the tubes that sucked us from place to place. But you know what? That's kind of it. We'll wait for the future yet another day. Anyway, we're off 22 points on the S&P cash. The markets have been very locked, especially the options, and we'll talk about that today at 4. You still have your opportunity to get in front of that by going to the front page of TFNN, signing up for my webinar, which starts at 4 tonight. We're going to talk about how options can help predict prices, especially at expiration, and why some people kind of have an idea. I'm going to say why those ideas that tend to be proglamated, if that's a word, in the internet at least missed 80% of the signal that you get from options. We'll talk about that. That's some other things, and really kind of a what I call an ensemble method. There's four or five things that I use to put together, not only for options, but everything else. When a lot of people ask me how I know the market's going sideways or a little down, I'll be able to explain it in both small words, I'm not going to get you into anything that looks like some ancient scribble from a mathematician 100 years before BC. It'll all be incredibly understandable. In fact, Einstein and other folks have always said something like that, which is, if you really know it well enough, you can explain it to a 10-year-old. And I'm not going to talk down to you, but I think that anybody with a basic junior high education could read it. In fact, in newspapers, they tell everybody to write for the eighth grade, because that's about it. Anyway, down 26 cents on the TLT. We'll keep an eye on that. Other than that, you don't want to see watch what the volume does. But, you know, other than it's coming a little sooner, who didn't know that when they started seeing all the inflation numbers in the last 30 days? Captain Obvious, I think he's going to win an Academy Award if he comes out there and acts like no one knew. But I think we kind of knew already, didn't we? But is it going to matter? Is any interest rate going to matter whatsoever to the big cap stocks on the NASDAQ, who all are sitting around with $100, $200 billion, $300 billion, able to buy back their shares at any time they want? Is it going to matter? Well, to the indexes, maybe no. Individual stocks, probably a lot more. If you need cash, probably a problem. If you're in a low-margin business, probably a problem. If you're making money, if you're printing money, if you're in software, if you're Microsoft, if you're in any of these companies that are virtual monopolies, I'm not worried about the price of money for those guys. I'm worried about antitrust coming to knock on their door. In fact, yesterday, the head of the is it SEC? Yeah. The gal, I can't remember her name right now. I'll think about it here in a minute. Has been writing papers about antitrust for the last 6 years. She is the inside go-to person for antitrust. Guess what she'll be able to do, Federal Trade Commission, SEC, and some of those other ones. So that's it. Don't think much is going on. If anything's going to happen, probably to those big companies, it'll probably be the antitrust issues. People leaving, like Jeff Bezos. Exiting stage right. This is the last time at being at Amazon, where he'll be hosting the earnings call. But that's about it. Anyway, we're just keeping a close eye on it. Of course, at the bottom of the hour, Powell will come on and take a presser. So he's warming up in the bullpen right now. Unless he says something really stupid, which, you know, he said some kind of things that moved the market before, but I wouldn't call them stupid. He'd have to get out of character. A lot of people concerned about it. But probably about 3:15, he'll be done, and we'll be able to move on with a market already in progress. Be back in a bit.
Are you grinding in the market, but seeing little to no return? Or are you a successful trader, simply looking to make your job a little easier? Learn to take the path of least resistance with David White's powerful trading newsletter. David White is an accomplished trader whose deep understanding of technology and the markets allows him to consistently find and share winning trades. Support and resistance define the ranges in which stocks trade. By understanding these trading ranges, David White is able to find the path of least resistance. David White's trading newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, is delivered daily before the markets open to make every trading day an easy win. Visit TFNN.com today and subscribe to David White's Ultimate Trading Newsletter for $119 a month. And try all of our newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Take the path of least resistance at TFNN, educating investors.
What's separating you from the most successful men and women on Wall Street? That's right, information. Having all the information gives us the perspective we need to place the right trades at the right time. The TASS Profile Scanner is the premier market profile-based scanner. Powered by its acclaimed TASS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner instantly filters over 2,500-plus global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. This powerful suite of tools leverages instant trade filtering and strategy formulation to show you emerging trades before they happen. For a limited time, you can save $100 off your first month by using the promo code UPGRADE, and you still get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Level the playing field with the TASS Profile Scanner, which you can find under the Services tab at TFNN.com. Sign up today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I'll personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hey, and we're back, and everybody's having probably some well-meaning jests at the Fed, as they pontificate. That's the word I was looking for earlier. The truth of the matter, the ground truth, is in the TLT, 140.56 off 50 cents. At a high of 141.67 early in the day. And, you know, does that change anything? 44 cents lower than yesterday? Not really. Probably see that churn a great deal. And then everybody will go, you know, that's next year, and we'll worry about it then. I don't think that, unless they talk about it happening 6 months, I don't think anybody's going to get that excited. I think there's a lot of talk, but that's it. I think the market's really concerned with government spending. And other than that, they're probably not worried about too much other. Anyway, we'll do a little history. We'll move on and start looking at some charts. And it's all history, just kind of rhyming. Doesn't really repeat, but it does rhyme.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
As we said, on this day in 1884, the first roller coaster in America opens at Coney Island in Brooklyn, New York, known as the Switchback Railway. It was the brainchild of LaMarcus Thompson, traveled approximately 6 miles per hour and cost a nickel to ride. Of course, that's, I guess you didn't ride on anything other than a train or a horse back then. The new entertainment was an instant success, and by the turn of the century, there were hundreds of roller coasters around the country. Of course, the big thing on Coney Island, I think it was 1923, was a giant roller coaster that really did something. It's still there. I want to say it's called the Tornado Cyclone. That's what it's called. And, of course, it's all there. Anyway, we'll keep an eye on it. TLT 140.72, not really thinking much else out here, but we'll keep a look for some spikes. S&P down 38 at the moment, Dow down 340, NASDAQ off 140, Russell down 18. That may be wrong. Crude's $71.99. Gold down $11. back into that trading range. See whether it can close below 1850 here today. Silver, down 4 cents. Not much going on there. So we'll keep an eye on it. Anyway, questions out here. And, of course, we were looking for a little lower from what options are going to tell us. We'll show those charts today at 4. But time to start looking at some charts. In fact, let's get to those right now as soon as I bring up the art of timing the trade charts. So we'll get that. Yesterday, in kind of the last few days, we were trying to get through the most heavily shorted stocks. So let's go ahead and get back to that list. We'll start from the end and work toward the front this time. Of course, these are all stocks with more than 6 days to cover. So we'll keep an eye on that. Zillow, be very interesting to see how this turns out today. A little kind of a hammer out here, fairly light volume, but the entire market will probably be it. Energy off just up, down just a little bit more in this last leg from May 28th, but right around 100 bucks, 103.67 is the last low out here with almost 4 million shares. Today you got about 2 million shares, so you want to keep an eye on that. But maybe that goes sideways out there and gets a dead cat bounce of some size if anything changes. Yum China down a little bit more today. Volume is light but heavily shorted. What else do we have? ZERS, which is Xeris Pharmaceuticals. This thing has popped up off the bottom with some massive volume. We had some good volume yesterday, just going sideways here today. Anywhere around 375-ish could be a nice pullback for that one, as short as it is. WU, which is Western Union. Guess we don't really need any pony riders anymore today. This is a company, of course, making most of its money for people sending money orders and money around to different places. I was at, what was that counter? Either Target or Walmart. I think it was at Walmart. And, of course, a bunch of people in there sending money back and forth to other folks, some back to their country of origin. But Western Union does that, makes some money. Light volume today so far. This one could be, if it can't close back in the trading range, a decent low. May 26 had 4.6 million shares. You get that with about 1.4 million shares. Just not that much money in it. But I guess with PayPal and Bitcoin, maybe people thinking that goes another way. Slack, pretty much going sideways, but heavy shorted. WIT, Wilpro Limited, down a little bit today. Volume's a little bit better. You'd like to see that at about $6.75, and everybody short. I don't see much in it now. Wayfair, another one of the lockdown stocks, has been making this big, what would you call it? A big asymmetrical triangle. A big triangle with lower highs and lower lows, and you're right in that now. This thing looks like it could have another week or so, and then it's going to bust out of this thing. Generally, you don't go any farther than the apex of a triangle, so you can put some nice lines on these and get a guess. But maybe another week, that thing looks like it would bust out. Generally, I wait for it because they almost bust out 80% to the wrong direction, then come back into the trading range and go the other way. I would watch that. We talked about some of these real estate ETFs hitting brand new highs just in the last few days. VNQ is one, Vornado hanging up here, and of course fairly light volume, but just monstrous volume. Generally, when these things are going to turn, you get a pretty good signal, and that is that they run all the shorts out at the high with a big spike intraday. VNQ is the other one we were talking about. Fairly lighter volume here today. Did hit 105.77 on June 10th with 4 million shares. You're kind of pulling back light. Yesterday, 4 million shares. Today, about 2.3. But again, we get into Thursday, probably going to be a lot better indication of how these stocks are doing long term. VICI, another one heavily shorted. No signal in that one. VIAV, nice spike here, and that's what I'm talking about when you get to stocks at highs that have big reversals. Got to 1814. What is it at now? 1782. And you got 40 cents out here. But you close back into the trading range. That's generally a fairly decent sign. You try to break out, you can't. Come back into the trading range, and that's it. We get back, we'll go through some more of these short stocks. As I said, I think everybody's probably getting a little bit too bearish going into Friday. That may set up some very nice fat trades for expiration. We'll be talking about it 4 o'clock today on the webinar.
Are you having fun trading the markets, but having trouble finding like-minded individuals to discuss your trading and investment ideas with? Become an apex predator in the trading markets and join the Tiger's Den Trading Room only at TFNN.com. The Tiger's Den is an exclusive trading room where successful traders from around the world come to exchange trades and ideas. Join the Den and surround yourself with the sharpest minds in the trading world. Subscribers to the Tiger's Den are also the first to have their questions answered live on air and can privately chat with our TFNN hosts live during their shows. Interact with other Tigers and Tigresses as they share trading ideas, news analysis, and discuss the market action all trading day. Subscribe to the Tiger's Den risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee and become part of the TFNN trading community. TFNN, educating investors.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we're, if this is right here, let's fast-moving market. Let's make sure I got it right. Down 32 points on the S&P cash, Dow down 316. NASDAQ off 98. And, of course, if we heard those numbers anywhere other than a Fed day, would anybody make much about it other than the market down a little bit? You know, if we were down 100 points, I'd make a lot bigger deal about it. I can't, though. Not much happening. TLT back to unchanged on the day, 141.03. And we've got some of these other stocks. Of course, after the bell tonight, we've got Lennar. be very interesting to see how the market reacts to it. Down $1.34 today. Did hit some highs at 110, came off. So down $20, which is what, 17%, is that right? Yeah, something like that. And of course, you're back into this candle where it actually drove much higher. That was on March 17th with 10 million shares, just kind of hanging out with 1.7 million shares today. So this is kind of the line of death, the line in the sand, the red line. We'll call it as many lines as we can. But this is where we're looking for it to hold. Question is not just what they say, but how they say it in the earnings call tonight. So you want to keep an eye on that. We also have Oracle, O-R-C-L, had earnings last night. They were down 5 or 6% almost from the opening. Got down to 75.90. We were talking about, I was baffled that they got back up to those highs. Must have just been running a lot of shorts, because I never saw that much new business coming Oracle's way. And we got the reversal here today. And, of course, kind of a bad day to be doing something where you miss anyway. That also goes for Lennar. If they do well, probably a little bit upside. If they say something the market doesn't like and we end up lower today, probably going to pay for it in doubles. Everything is beautiful in its own way. Da, 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 da. I know that song from somewhere, and I can't remember. I used to play it. Yeah, someone will tell me the title of it. That's going to drive me nuts here for a while. Other questions out here. Do I see anything else going on the memes? You can email me at path@tfnn.com, and I'll check my spam and junk mail folders a little bit more often during the show. Question about Adobe yesterday. Did we get to that? I think we did. ADBE. And yeah, you're back at support. So you had a nice breakout with volume. 536.88 was that September 2nd high. You had about 3 million shares. You busted it with a little over 3 million shares, came back, but you know, getting pretty close to support. What's the low of the day? Yeah, 537. So that wouldn't be a bad trade if you are feeling froggy on Adobe and the NASDAQ decides to firm up in the next couple of days. Because guess what? It needs to close above 536.88, or you're on the wrong side of that. But decent high volume moves above 4 million through that high. You're pulling back on fairly light volume. You had a nice run, which is probably the biggest problem, and maybe a completed ABC. You know, support comes in 536.88. Okay. Other things going on out here? Okay. Any more on the nuclear fallout? As I said yesterday, I figured you probably wouldn't hear much about it. Not another peep as far as I could see. Coming back a little bit. My guess is that the stock was just kind of up there. Probably some people were short this thing and decided that whatever the Chinese were saying, they could blow it up. With nuclear power, probably a pretty easy thing to do. You had that big down day, kind of coming back a little bit more to $20 mark. And, of course, during options expiration, hey, maybe a lot of people had a lot of $20 calls and they wanted to blow them up, just like the story. But, you never know where these things are going to come from. Give me a call, 877-927-6648. Vantage, heavily shorted, 1481 a few days ago. And not that much pullback, very light volume so far today. Kind of looks like it wants to go to 1572, which is not that much higher, but certainly problematic. See what else do we have out here. Perpetually short Under Armour has come back. It's at support levels. Volume's fairly good. I'll have to look at this one harder because This one's got a lot of shorts in it. Maybe there's a decent play out there for expiration. I'll have to check it. But certainly you're at support levels. And a T-shirt manufacturer, I don't know how much interest rate's going to change people buying Under Armour stuff. I think a bigger issue for that is what we talked about yesterday was baseball, football, basketball, the major drivers of things like Nike and Under Armour have been underwatched. The people in the golf course realm have been doing the BAFO business. But let's take a quick look at Nike, because I didn't really think about that real quick. NKE. This thing looks like it's coming back. Get some decent volume back on the 20th of April, 13.2 million shares. You're getting into that with a doji out here of $130. This does look like it's probably in a bigger trading range. The downside is 125.44, the March 25th low. If this is just a consolidation out here, 142.50 would be halfway through this gap down that goes back to the 19th. They must have earnings coming up here shortly. See, do I have anything on that? NKE. Earnings Thursday, June 24th. Okay, so you got 7-8 days. And I'd like a little better play on this, but my guess, these people are short out the wazoo on this one, and I wonder if they want to hold through earnings. June 24th. Couple of days to cover. See what they've been doing here lately. Yeah, it's really not that bad. Mostly in the single digits to maybe low two-digit short percentages. So there's not much there either. Holding up Nike. Probably better trades out there then. Other moves out here. Let's see if our list. Sabre. Talking to some pilots, they're calling them all back. They're having problems. A lot of the people that got laid off last year on one airline are looking at switching to another one and starting as captains on others. But you know what? By the end of the year, we won't have anywhere close to enough pilots to go back into the air. And we're back to 2019 levels of flight already, basically enough. We'll be back in.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
And we got some action here now, down 36 points on the S&P cash. Got to say, of the headlines here I'm reading from it, he's not trying to get the market any higher, kind of throwing a little bit of cold water. Down 35 points in the S&P cash, Dow down 308, NASDAQ off 137, Russell off 15. So not much happening in that. We'll keep an eye on some of the other ones. Gold down $14.15 now. And silver off 17 cents. No big deal on the silver. Let's get this back up. You can give me a call, 877-927-6648. You can email me at path@tfnn.com. Anyway, we were talking about that. Let's go ahead and look at some of these other ones. Oh, we were talking about Sabre. Let's take a quick look at Boeing. You know, down a little bit today. Wouldn't say that there's much volume so far. This would right be at where support should be. You gapped up with 18.4 million shares, down with 7 today. At 18 million shares higher came on the 27th of May, where you gapped up, and now you're back at what should be support. I don't know if I'm a big fan of this. But guess what? I'm going to be watching those options the next couple of days because this one's right at support. Could it bounce higher? You know, anything's possible. But things are going good, at least in the airlines. Higher fuel rates problematic. But if they can get the pilots, they'll be back in the air better. In fact, I was hearing some discussions this morning that they may get the age rate for senior pilots up. What is it, 62 now? 65. Talking about moving that to maybe 68. And no replacement for experience. But if Boeing fails here, the real support comes at this double gap at 230. Other than a 1 or 2 day option play, the smart money would be to be long at 230. Okay, down 40 on the S&P cash. Man, okay, keeping an eye out here. See what else is here. Okay. Patterson Energy. Just holding up there. I don't see much there. Question about Peloton, P-T-O-N, Peloton. I haven't looked at this one for a while. Of course, this one, a few things had kind of hit it. But, man, talk about light volume. Almost 2 weeks going sideways out here. You're back into support going back to May 26th. That day had 26.6 million shares up. You got 6 million shares on the way down. not a huge fan of this thing, but could it go back up to this retest, this trading range to 124.80? It could. But even now, in the next few days, could it get back up to 115, which is resistance? You never know. You get some more bad news on the pandemic front. You can always find that. What else do we have? Mitch, which is Match Group. Talk about a stock going sideways. Didn't get down in the previous low. Tried back on May 19th. It's just been going sideways for a while. This one looks like it's going to take off. We'll see. Maybe it's another one of these with earnings coming up shortly. MTCH, right? MTCH. Tuesday, August 3rd. So you got a little bit of time. You got 45 days, 48 days. So there's nothing in here that much. Not exactly sure why this thing goes so sideways. Probably not affected by interest rates at all. Whatever is going on, this is the triangle pattern that you can start drawing your triangle from the low of March 30th, right up here, and off of the high of April 29th. So yeah, maybe another week on these triangle patterns. A lot of them look like they're about ready to get to the apex of that triangle, and then you wait for it to break, and generally fade it is the right answer, i.e. take the opposite side. If it goes higher, start shorting it. If it goes lower, start buying it. Candy, I haven't talked about this one for a while. Of course, the Indian-based electric car company. It's done well, 420. Is the May 11th low, 2.2 million shares, got to $6.68, so a fairly nice bounce out here. Again, monster shorts. I don't know if anything would change that, like maybe a problem with oil, but keep an eye on it. Iron Mountain, we've talked about this one for a while. They hide all the backups that apparently no one's making, or they wouldn't have to pay ransomware. But a company big in putting together old iron and copper mines, because they're basically shielded from any EMF. They can put them back in there. They all tend to be rather dry mines that these guys buy. But they've already done all the mining and digging the holes, so all they have to do is go in there and put a front door on the thing. Maybe a back door if there's an exit out the other side. Put some air conditioning in it, finish the walls, and you got a great place to store stuff that, short of a nuclear hit, is still going to be around. Monster shorts in this. You always wonder whether or not somebody will talk about buying them out or something. But generally, probably not going to buy them out other than to run all the shorts. But we all know how that goes. 877-927-6648. Yeah. Tried to bust out the bottom. Didn't quite do that. Down 38 points on the S&P. Of course, the big thing to watch is the 10-year. Really started making a drive for that 1.6 level. Last I saw, it was at 1.57. I don't have it up here right now. TLT down 31 cents, but that's the one to watch over the next couple of days to actually see. Talked about Lennar being out after the bell. That'll be a good bellwether to look at first thing in the morning and see how that reacts. And we had a lot of other stocks out here. Question to look at SGMO, which I was looking at just the other day, down 34 cents. Looks like this thing's trying to base out. You might need one more test around $10 on light volume. Yesterday, a million shares. Today, just 400,000 shares. But certainly right around this 1050 does look like fairly decent support. It's in the right sector. It's a little different than the ones I like. But monster shorts, but not a lot of action yet. We'll be back in a minute. We'll be right back.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chetman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chetman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chetman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive. We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
And we're back. Question in the den, unless everybody front question in the den could the Thursday night Fed juice be a thing. And of course, you know, they're putting $40 billion in. I haven't seen anything. Of course, I'm on the air. Be interesting to see if there's any discussion about them tapering any of that right now. Haven't seen it. My guess, though, is they wouldn't just go $40 billion and then zero. They'd be bringing it back. But I don't see any headlines that say that. Maybe somebody in the den can go back and look. But as far as I can tell, you know, the only thing changing is the fact that everybody's figured it out and they started front running it last Thursday. The question is, do they start front running it at the close today, in the last couple of minutes or something like that? So we'll keep an eye on it. My guess is that we'll probably see a lot of people be very dispirited today, maybe try to short the close, and then they'll run them right back out again as they have for the last 10 years. Every time everybody gets a sour look on their face, the market likes to run the shorts out. Occasionally you've been right. In fact, a couple of times we've been right to the short side. But normally on a macro level, just talking about expiration the next couple of days, we start seeing a lot of people going south. I'll be trying to look for a nice pop into Friday. If we don't see anybody shorting today, when we get the numbers tonight, I'm going to be thinking that maybe today wasn't enough. to get people all bearish, and maybe it'll take a little bit more downtown to get it that way. But generally, if we're moving down today, going to think that a lot of people are getting short. And, you know, does it have to pop much? No, it just has to get to Friday afternoon. These guys are on the wrong side. And, of course, what do? They cover. So that's about it. Webinar tonight, I'll be talking with Tom about that in the next segment in his show. Other than that, go to the front page of TFNN, sign up for the webinar. We're going to be going through a lot of these charts that I've developed for looking at options expiration. You want to be there? Be square.